that in these five books, no less than 700 times, you will read the expression, and the Lord said unto Moses, and Moses said unto the Lord, and the Lord said unto Moses, and Moses said unto the Lord. When you start just on the very superficial view of these phrases, you can understand that the Lord didn't write it, nor did Moses write it. See, it's third party. Somebody else is telling you what he has heard, maybe from hearsay, that you see these were words given by God to Moses, and Moses again spoke like this and like that. If Hazrat Musa alayhi salam, Moses, if he had written these words, if he had noted them down, he would have said, and the Lord said unto me, and I said unto the Lord, and I spoke to the Lord, and the Lord said unto me. That's in the first person. This is somebody writing in the third person. That means, you know, speaking from hearsay. So Allah didn't dictate it, nor did Musa alayhi salam write it. Very face of it. So can you blame the biblical scholars for telling us that Moses didn't write it? Put them in inverted commas. No, you can't blame them. Then in the last chapter of the last book, supposed to be the book of Moses, in the book of Deuteronomy, chapter 34, we read about the obituary of Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. You know, obituary, when a man dies, you put some nice, beautiful epitaphs on his tombstone. You know, this, here lies Mr. Ahmad Didat, one of the great comparative study, you know, scholars, students of religion, and so on and so on. You know, you might put it, after I'm gone. Obituary. So, Hazrat Musa alayhi salam is supposed to have written his own obituary. Listen. It says, and there Moses died in the land of Moab. He died. He's alive, but he died in the land of Moab, over against Beth Peor. And no man knoweth of his sepulchre unto this day. No man knows about where his grave is up to today. Is this man walking in flesh and blood? Is he telling you that his grave is somewhere and nobody knows where it is today, up to today? Did he write that? That he died when he's alive? Doesn't he know his language? That this is past tense? He's still alive and he says, I died? Oh, he could have made a prophecy. Like, if I were to make a prophecy, I says, you know, I'm going to all over the country. I will be visiting Washington. And, you know, I will die there in Washington. And Reagan will attend my funeral. Maybe it will never happen, anything like that. But can you see now, I can say that now. That I think, well, you know, I had a dream or somebody tickled me and I heard some voices to say this is what is going to happen. I can tell you that I will die in Washington, D.C. And Reagan and Mrs. Reagan, they will attend my funeral. But, you know, when I'm still alive, how can I say that I died in Washington, D.C. and Reagan was there? How can I say that? That I died when I'm talking to you now. I'm alive. Hazrat Musa alayhi salam could never have uttered those words, that he died. Then it says, and Moses was. This is simple grammar, simple basic English, you know. And Moses was 120 years old when he died. Musa alayhi salam, he's telling you that I was 120 years old when I died, when he's still alive. And his natural powers had not abated. You know, physically, he was still fit. I think I'm fit, physically. I'm 69. He was twice my age. But he was fit. The wordings convey that if he had another 16-year-old for a wife, he could have done justice to her. You know, his natural powers, physical powers, sexual powers had not abated. He was still strong. Did Musa alayhi salam say that? You know, you think he would talk like that? Telling people, he says, you know, I'm still all right. No. These are not his words. And there arose not a prophet since in Israel like unto Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face. Since in Israel. Since when? Did Musa say that? No. Can you see on the very face of it, these books are not the books of Hazrat Musa alayhi salam. And hence, they are not the word of God.